Did you know that there's a feature in Steam that can be used to easily collect data on how your game is being played? Data like which game modes your players are enjoying the most, which items are overpowered, and which levels your players are struggling with. This kind of data can be extremely valuable for various purposes. For example, to figure out how to balance your game. In this video, I'll talk a bit about the Steam Stats feature, how it could potentially be used for data-driven game development, and I will also show in practice how you can easily start using this feature in your own game. Hi, my name is Auro, I'm a full-time indie game developer, creator of Mortal Glory, and currently working on a game called Chambers of Devious Design. On top of that, I also make these weekly YouTube videos sharing my experiences to help you on your own game dev journey. Okay, let's start with the topic. I remember reading an article about Slay the Spire, how the developers were collecting gameplay data and how they were able to use that data to efficiently balance their game. I remember thinking that was such a cool idea, especially since it was just two guys behind the game. It probably saved them a lot of time when they had actionable data to tell them where to focus their efforts. Now, I don't know how they collected the data, but I noticed that Steam has their own feature for collecting gameplay data, and I thought I would give it a try. Before we get too excited, I do need to say as a disclaimer though that Steam Stats isn't meant for analytics. The features are very limited as its main purpose is to track how players are progressing through your game. And obviously, there's no cross-platform support. You can only use it within Steam. The way I see it, Steam Stats can be used as an easy data collection tool for doing some light analytics. But if you're looking for some serious analytics that you want to use as a basis for major decisions, you should probably go with something else that gives you more capabilities. There is one nice special perk to using Steam Stats though, but I'll talk more about that towards the end of the video. Alright, so let's take a quick look at what the Steam Stats can do. It can track three different types of variables in your game: ints, floats, and average rates. The average rate is basically a number that is associated with a specific period of time. For example, how many points a player has earned in 1 hour. With each of these stat types, you can set some ground rules like can they be set by a client or a server? Can the stat only go up? How much can the stat change at once? What is the minimum value of the stat? What is the maximum value of the stat? And what is the default value of the stat? For average rates, there is also the window setting, which defines what the time period for that stat is. And then finally, there is an important setting called aggregated. This setting is what makes it possible to use Steam Stats for analytics. Basically, it means that the stat values from all players are pooled together. So, if you have a stat called games won and you have 3 players with each of them having won 5 games, the aggregated value of this stat will be 15. By dividing that aggregated value by the number of players, you can then get interesting values like the average win rate of your players. That's everything there is to know about the features. It's very bare bones, but we can still put it to good use. For example, in my new game, I am planning on tracking basic things like the amount of wins and the amount of losses players have. But on top of that, I was thinking of tracking what kinds of rune types and how many of those rune types the players have on the board when they are winning and when they are losing. This way, I should be able to see if, for example, red rooms are overrepresented in games that are won, potentially indicating that they are too good as is. There are a lot of useful things you could get data on to help with making changes. Now, let me show how you can start using the feature in your own game. First, we need to create some stats in here. You can access this section from the Steamworks settings and navigate into the Stats and Achievements section. So, let's create a few stats for testing. When you are doing this, you might need to disable your ad blocker if you have one. At least, I needed to do this before I could actually create new stats. Once you have created some stats, don't forget to publish the changes. You will need to do this or the stats won't actually be created. In order to affect these stats from within your game, you will need Steam integration in your game. I recently made a video on how you can easily accomplish that. So if you haven't done it yet, I recommend checking that video out first. I'll include the link in the description. Assuming you have the Steam integration in place, setting stats in your game is actually really easy. You just need to call this method called steamworks.steamuserstats.setstat. As an input, it requires the ID of the stat and the value you want to set the stat to. This will set a local version of the stat, but to ensure the new value actually gets saved to Steam servers, you still need to also call the StoreStats method. Ideally, the StoreStats method shouldn't be constantly called, so a good practice would be to use the setStat always when the stat changes, but only call the StoreStats now and then, for example at the end of a level. But yeah, basically, only these two methods are needed to use the Steam stats system. You can also read the stat values within the game with getStatInt and getStatFloat if needed. Let's see if this works in practice. Here I am first checking what the stat values are before I do anything. I then set each of my three stats to have different values so they stand out from each other. After setting them, I check the new values, which match with what I set them to. Seems to work great. Except there's one issue. My stat2a and stat3a were aggregated stats. So they also have a global value that is combined from the values that all players have in that stat. Those are the values I am actually interested in. The values I saw printed earlier were player-specific values. How do I know that? Well, I actually earlier adjusted those stats with another Steam account also. Unfortunately, the FacePunch API wrapper doesn't yet seem to have a command for reading the global aggregated values. But worry not, there is another way to get the global values. Steam has a web API that can actually be accessed by anyone. And luckily for us, there's a method in there that we can use to get the global values for our game. We can just enter the method address to our browser, and with the right parameters, we can see the global values we were looking for. As a nice bonus, the numbers actually match with the values I entered for the two different accounts within my game. Let's quickly unpack how this web API method works. First, there's the address that never changes, and after that, we get to the parameters. As the first parameter, you need to give the ID of your game, which you can find on your Steamworks page. Then, as the next parameter, we need to tell the API how many values we want to see. The number needs to be exact. After that, we need to specify each stat we want to check, while following the proper format and a running numbering. We could also limit the search based on dates, but that is not necessary. It's good to note that you cannot use this method to get values for stats that aren't set as aggregated. There's another method for that. The value changes also aren't quite real time, and I noticed that sometimes I needed to use a different device or change my IP with a VPN to get the new values faster. But if you're checking the values just now and then, it shouldn't be an issue. So that's how you can check the values. It would be great if you could see the values within Steam also, but they haven't quite gotten around to adding that feature just yet. Although, bookmarking the API query in your browser is still faster, and you can also use other means to access the web API. For example, here's a simple Python script I wrote to get the stat values. It does the same thing, but it's a bit easier to adjust which stats to get. As a further improvement, I could have this run automatically and save the values to a CSV file or something like that. Alright, so now you can set and check the stat values. There are also some additional methods for resetting the stats and things like that, but I won't go deeper into those. In the beginning, I teased that there is one special perk to using Steam stats. Let's talk a bit about that. It's related to data privacy. Quick disclaimer, I am not a data privacy specialist, nor do I want to be one. The following is just my own thoughts and interpretations on the subject. So, at least within the EU, there are regulations related to data privacy, which all companies operating the EU must follow. This collection of regulations is better known as the GDPR. Now, GDPR is mostly focused on protecting the personal information of customers, and things like games won within your indie game don't really count as personal information. But as far as I know, GDPR also mandates that you must tell the users of your service what kind of data is collected about them, for what purpose, and they must also opt in to the collection of that data. Having small print text hidden somewhere also isn't enough. The user must give a clear consent, usually by clicking a button that says, "Yes, I am okay with my data being collected." I haven't really followed how the GDPR has affected games, but I checked two popular game analytics services, Game Analytics and Unity Analytics. On their sites, they both say that if you are using these services, you as a game developer should ask for consent from your players before any data is collected. If they don't consent, you cannot collect data from those players. Okay, but what does this have to do with Steam stats? Well, if you check Steam's privacy agreement, which I assume all Steam users have agreed to, there's a mention that Steam will collect data about your use of games on Steam, game statistics, and so on. Based on this, my interpretation is that data collection done through Steam stats is covered by Steam's privacy agreement. And because of that, if you use Steam stats in your game, there's no need to ask consent from your players anymore, as they have already consented to it through Steam. But I am not a data privacy specialist, so I decided to ask Steam support about this. Turns out, they agree with my interpretation. So, in conclusion, one benefit Steam stats has over other data collection tools is that there's no need to include a separate notice about data collection in your game. And you yourself also don't need to keep track of whose data you can legally collect and whose you cannot, as that falls to Steam to manage. Now, of course, if we are being realistic, it is very unlikely that your small indie game will be flagged for violating GDPR, even if you collect gameplay data without consent, as long as you are not doing it maliciously. But if we go by the letter of the law, well, my interpretation of it, by using Steam stats, you can collect non-personal gameplay data without including a separate notice and an opt-out form in your game while still adhering to the GDPR. Phew, that was quite a tangent, but I thought it was an interesting perk for Steam stats that most people are probably overlooking. I hope at least some of you found it interesting. And that's where I will end this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.